Welcome, kids, to another exciting episode of Kids Church Online, where we'll be walking through the scrapbook of my life, where memories were made that helped grow my identity as a child of God. These special memories would never have been made if not for the amazing people I've met and come to know, especially those I journey with here at my church. For today's lesson, we'll be focusing on the importance of our role as godly children in the church. I hope you're ready for an adventure. Let's jump in. I never knew how important family in the church was to us as the children of God until I heard Pastor William's message that day. I was so encouraged by hearing how important it is to belong and need each other in the church. So I asked if he wouldn't mind sharing this message with all of you again today. Let's press play and have a listen.
Wow, what a past few weeks it's been. Guys, haven't you learned so much? God created you. He loves you. You're His child. He's transforming you. He's gifted you. He's made you to worship. He's blessed you and He leads you. He's also your friend. And wow, with all of that, you know what? He places you in the church. Just imagine with me, if you will, one day you went fishing and you were standing there on the seaside shore and you cast that line the furthest you've ever done. And you were waiting and you're waiting. And then you got the biggest tug and you pulled in what was the biggest fish you had ever seen. But you know what? No one was there to experience it with you. You did it all alone. Wouldn't be quite the same, hey? Imagine too, if you like sport, you were playing golf. You know, that first shot, it's called teeing off, and you hit that ball, and when you whacked it, it went straight into the hole, and you just threw your club up. You were so excited, but no one was there to experience it with you. It was just you. It wouldn't be the same, would it, hey? You know, it's never the same when we're not doing the greatest things with the ones we love, isn't it? You know what? When you were a little baby, just brand new, just born, what did you need the most? Just think about it. What did you need? Did you need love? You needed to be cared for? You needed food? And how did you get all these things? Yeah, you guessed it, from your mommy and your daddy. And if you didn't have them, well, you wouldn't be around. You wouldn't have survived. You wouldn't have lived. Same with God's children. They're not meant to be alone. They're meant to be in His family, in God's family. It's called the church. Did you say, I thought church was a place that I go to on Sundays? I know it sounds crazy, but actually, we as children, God's children, when we come together, we're the church. Maybe we should say that the church is coming to the building on Sundays. I know it sounds crazy. But actually, that's what's happening when we as children come together. We are the church. Let's think a little bit more about that. You know your home, that place you love, where you live, where no one's there. It's just a house. It's empty. It's exactly the same with the church building. It's empty when you guys aren't here. But when we're together, when God's family is together, that makes it so special. Just like when you're all together at home. It's just such a wonderful place to be, isn't it? So what do you love about your home? Maybe it's the yummy suppers that your mom makes for you every night. Or those bedtime stories that your daddy reads to you. Or maybe you just love playing with your neighbors and your friends in the backyard. You know, with all that fun, and there's loads of it, there come some other things too, hey, like making your bed in the morning, or packing away the dishes, putting your clothes in the wash basket and not on the floor. Maybe you even have to pick up the doggy, you know. So home's definitely a place where you get a lot of good stuff, we know that. But it's also a place where we have to give, especially as we get older. But you know, that's how family works. It just works better when we all do our bit. It just makes it a special place to belong to. And that's just a wonderful thing, isn't it? God's family is exactly the same. He made the family at your home very much like the family at church. And you know what? The family at the church works pretty much like the family at the home. So everyone has a special place and everyone has a special work. And we all get the privilege of being it, doing it, and enjoying it together. The church is God's family on earth. And that's why you, God's child, belong in the church. He'd have it no other way than you being with him and his family. Let's pray. God, thank you for the family. Thank you for the church. Father, thank you so much that you want us to be together. Father, would you keep us together so that we can show the world the best family ever, so that they too will want to be a part of the church, your family. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
How encouraging was this message today, kids? I hope you know how important you are to the church and all its people. Let this memory verse wash over your hearts as we read this together. And let us not abandon our meeting together as some people do, but encourage one another, especially now that the day of his return is drawing near. Hebrews 10, verse 25. Let's all worship Jesus together as a church family.
To count the stars, nothing could
Wow. Whew. I have truly enjoyed all these amazing adventures throughout my scrapbook. It's our last lesson for this series, and I hope you enjoyed this time together. My encouragement for you as we end today is to make time getting to know God more and more, as He wants to shape you to become the best you can be in every area of your life, because He loves you and wants the best for you as His child. As I say my last goodbye, kids, remember to keep safe, meet with Jesus daily, and keep walking in all that God has for you as a child of God. Love you always.